Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to change the styling of some design elements on PowerPoint slides. Particularly, I want to change things that are not necessarily easy to get to. For instance, I've got a little PowerPoint presentation here, and several of the slides have these lines right up at the top. This is pretty common. Most slide design templates will have some visual or design element that are part of the slide. For instance, I can click on this title. I can click on these numbered lists, but I can't click on these lines, these visual elements at the top. However, I can still get to them. If I go to my view ribbon and then click on Slide Master, I can start to access things that I normally couldn't access. And in fact, on Slide Master, you get all these little thumbnails. These are basically masters for the various layouts. The very top one though, that's the one I'm gonna go to. I'm gonna click on that master title style, that master layout thumbnail right up there at the very top. And notice now I can click on these little lines up here. So check this out, I'm gonna click on that middle one. I'm going to rotate it a bit. And let's see, I'll go to shape format, shape fill, and let's make it something different. How about the purple? I'm gonna reduce the rotation on there a little bit. What else can I do? Double click. Shape effects. How about a shadow on there? Let's put a shadow on it. Something that stands out, but doesn't. Yeah, there we go. Little subtle shadow in there. Great. So what does that really do for me? Well, let's find out. I can go back to my view menu, and then I can go to normal view again. And I'll see that most of my slides that had those elements have that vertical line, but not all of them. I do have this one problem slide. I used a design suggestion from PowerPoint a little bit earlier to create this, and it kind of is superseding that particular design element. It's pretty easy to fix. If I right click in a blank area of this particular slide and I go to my layout options, notice that all of my layouts do have that angled line now. The one I chose before was, I think it was this one, the content with caption. I'm gonna click that again, and there I've got my purple slanted design element. It did make my slide background gray, so I'm just gonna right click on a blank area of that slide, format background, and I'll change that background to white to fit with the others, and now it's gonna have that same basic look as these other elements. Cool. And so there we go. So it's the slide master which is the real trick to all of this. And if I head back into view, Slide Master, you'll notice all of my little Slide Master thumbnails have that slanty purple line, but of course I can change my mind, go back to the original, the master one, the top one there, rotate it the other way, change the color out to bright red, view, back to normal view, and now all of those slides are going to have that restyled visual element. So there we go. So Slide Master is the trick. Great. If you are in my CIS 120 class or my CIS 101 class, hang around for a bit because I'm going to show you what I want you to do for an extra credit skill related to PowerPoint. Thanks. Okay, so if you're still watching, then hopefully you're one of my CIS 101 or 120 students. I'm not making direct reference to this in our assignment activities, but this video is going to be a resource, and this is just an extra credit opportunity for those that followed through and watched the whole video and want to earn a few extra points related to their PowerPoint assignment. So let's see, here's what I'm going to want you to do. File, new, create yourself a new PowerPoint. And let's get something that already has some element. Now, for the most part, it's not gonna matter what you pick. However, let's try to get something good here. Maybe this Future Forward. This is pretty similar to what I just worked with. So Future Forward, and you notice it's got those three lines at the top. That looks pretty cool. Now, if you don't have this particular template in your PowerPoint selection, maybe you're using a different PowerPoint version than I am, get something similar. For instance, here's something that looks like it has a visual element right up there that's pretty distinctive. This one I know has been around for a long time. Ion has that little square up there. That's been around for decades, I think. So I'm gonna pick Future Forward. Then I'm just gonna click Create. Excellent, cool. Let's just kind of ignore most of that. I'm gonna create a new slide, and here's what I want you to do. Create a new slide, and you're gonna have a styled, numbered list. I want you to produce a slide that has two columns of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a numbered list 1 through 6 that's going to look like this. So there you go. I want a generic 6-item list 1, 2, and 3 on the left, 4, 5, and 6 on the right, and I want those numbered items to be really big and red. I want them definitely to look different from before. I also want you to adjust the spacing. I want more space in between the list items, and I want you to add a little bit more space in between the number and the list item text. So it should look very, very close to this one. That's not everything though. I'm also going to create another new slide, and this one doesn't really, the content isn't too important. Style visual elements. Okay, now this particular slide has these three lines right up at the top, and if you just watched this past video, you have a feeling for how to do this part. So I want you to change these out. Change out your visual elements so that it's really clear to me that you were able to do it. And if you're doing the slide design template that has these three lines, the finished product should look kind of like this. And there we go. So now those three lines up there are distinctly different. So they are certainly larger. They're a different color. I did add a bevel to them as well. So do several things that are very distinctive that'll let me know that you know how to change those design elements. So those are the two things that I'm looking for on your PowerPoint. I'm looking for some restyled numbers for a numbered list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, left and right. Nice and big red numbers. And then definitely on all of these slides, notice the visual element has now changed that I had up at the top. Instead of three distinctly skinny little lines, I've now got three larger lines, different colors with a bevel on them. Okay, what are you gonna do with that? Well, you're gonna save that PowerPoint, send it to me via email, and because I'm kind of hiding this extra credit at the end of a video, I don't think many students are going to notice it. So don't worry about bombarding me with emails, just go ahead and send that over to me and I will add some extra credit points to your PowerPoint related assignment. Cool, thank you for doing this, take care.